tropical evergreen forest, tropical deciduous forest, and thorny bushes. Now, the turn of mangroves, deltaic vegetation, mangroves. Deltaic vegetation. Mangroves of deltaic vegetation. Deltaic vegetation. Such kind of a vegetation has generally lies in a deltas of India. In our country, there are five rivers which makes as a deltas. Five rivers makes delta. First, Ganga in West Bengal. Ganga, the combined stream of Ganga and Brahmaputra makes the Sundarbans in Bangladesh. But another stream of Ganga, it makes as the delta in West Bengal. In West Bengal. It makes a delta in West Bengal. Second, Kaveri. Kaveri. The first river as a Ganga makes as a delta. Ganga makes a delta in West Bengal. Second, Kaveri in Tamil Nadu. Kaveri in Tamil Nadu makes a delta. Kaveri in Tamil Nadu. Next, Mahanadi in Odisha. Mahanadi in Odisha. Here is a Chilika Lake. Mahanadi in Odisha. Next, Krishna. Krishna in Andhra Pradesh. Krishna and Godavari in Andhra Pradesh. Krishna and Godavari in Andhra Pradesh. Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Mahanadi, Ganga. So, in these five rivers, the delta regions are known for the mangroves. Yes, Renuka, mangroves.
Sir, actually, I joined just Renuka. Now. What are we doing? Can please tell?
Yes, Renuka. Wait a minute. Yes.
सर मैंने अभी ज्वाइन किया अब बता दो हमने क्या किया अभी तक
वी जस्ट बिगिन एज सम मैंग्रोव्स और डेल्टाइक वेजिटेशन इंडियास फाइव रिवर्स व्हिच मेक्स एज अ डेल्टा इन ईस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन्स नोन फॉर द मैंग्रोव्स द लोकेशन ऑफ अ मैंग्रोव्स कावेरी इन तमिलनाडु कृष्णा गोदावरी इन आंध्र प्रदेश महानदी इन उड़ीसा एंड गंगा इन वेस्ट बंगाल सो दीज फाइव रिवर्स where they make as a delta, these regions are known for the mangroves. These regions are known for the location of a mangroves. These forests occur in around the deltas and estuaries. Around the deltas and estuaries. We learned in a third chapter of a drainage. Estuary means as a funnel-shaped structure when river directly falls in a larger water body through the rocky surfaces. But a delta is a triangular piece of land formed by the river at its mouth when river starts to divide it into the distributaries. So these forests are generally occur around the deltas, estuaries of the rivers. This kind of a vegetation is also known as a tidal forest. These are also known as the tidal forest. Such forest, it can be as grow in a saline water. This is as the quality of a mangroves. They can grow in a saline water. Saline water. In saline water, such kind of a vegetation can possible to grow. They can grow in a saline water. Mangroves are generally other trees and shrubs that grow in saline and brackish coastal habitats in the tropics and the subtropical regions. Mangroves can live in the most inundated areas where swamplands or marshy lands are developed due to accumulation of sediments and water. Those lands where as the marshy lands are developed due to as an accumulation of water on a surface, such marshy lands, wetlands are supportive for growth of mangroves. They support for the growth of mangroves. Mangroves are beneficial for the us. Mangroves are beneficial for us. I'm again repeating as a mangroves, which are generally as the trees, deltaic or tidal forest, Renuka. Deltaic forests or mangroves are also known as a tidal forest. Mangroves are the trees and shrubs that grow in a saline or brackish water. Another term which is used for a saline water as a brackish water. Brackish water. B-R-A-C-K-I-S-H. Brackish water, which has generally associated at the places of a coastal regions. Such mangroves can live in a most inundated areas. Inundated means as a wetlands, marshy lands. Inundated areas. Inundated areas or wetlands, marshy lands. Mangroves can grow in a wetlands, in saline water. In saline water. Mangroves are highly beneficial for us. So how does that mangroves beneficial for us? The growth of mangroves in a coastal regions. Coastal regions, it protected coast from the tidal waves. Mangroves protect the coastal regions from tidal waves, sea waves, tsunamis. As you learned in a tides has a diurnal process. It's a daily process which has influenced due to the gravitational pull of sun and moon. Due to gravitational pull of sun and moon, tides are occur. When tidal waves, sea waves, or tsunamis, they are striking over a coastal regions, it may lead as the erosion. Erosion of a rocks lies in a coastal regions. So under such circumstances, if the mangroves are growing in a coastal regions, they are supportive for a protection of coast from tidal waves. Protection of coast from sea waves. Clear? First, mangroves are beneficial for us because it protect the coast from a tidal waves. Second, mangroves are generally growing in a deltas. Such deltas are rich in a fertile soils. Fertile soils. So mangroves are supportive for the growth of mangroves are supportive for cultivation of crops. Mangroves are supportive for production of crops. Mangroves are given as a natural habitat to the animals. Variety of animals are generally living in a mangroves. Bengal tiger. Sundarbans has considered the home of a royal Bengal tiger. Bengal tiger. Clear? Bengal tiger. Mangroves are the home of Bengal tiger. Next, a large number of tribal communities are inhabiting in such areas of mangroves. Tribals living in mangroves. Tribal communities living in larger in number in mangroves. Tribal communities living in mangroves. So mangroves are beneficial for us. So next one is the number of species of trees which are growing in mangroves. Species of trees which are growing in mangroves. Those number of species of trees which are growing in mangroves. First as a Sundari. SUNDARI. Sundari species of trees are preferably growing in our mangroves. Sundari species of trees are preferably growing in our mangroves. The other number of trees are the palm, P-A-L-M, palm. First, Sundari, S-U-N-D-A-R-I, Sundari. Second, palm, P-A-L-M, P-A-L-M. First, Sundari. Second, palm. Third, agar, A-G-A-R, A-G-A-R. Fourth, coconut, coconut. Fifth, keora, K-E-O-R-A, K-E-O-R-A, K-E-O-R-A. Yes, mostly as a Sundari growing in a mangroves. Fourth, keora, K-E-O-R-A, K-E-O-R-A. So these number of trees are generally growing in a mangroves, in a deltaic vegetation, or we can say as a tidal forest. The number of species of animals which are generally growing in a mangroves are, which are present in a mangroves are Bengal tiger, gharials, snakes. Number of species of snakes are present in a mangroves, gharials, crocodiles, turtles, snakes, tiger are generally found in a mangroves. They are generally found in mangroves. So any questions still there? Next, the fifth category, fifth type of a vegetation is the mountain vegetation. Any questions? Yes, Renuka.
Sir, please repeat the species of animals found in mangroves.
Tiger, snakes, gharial, crocodiles. Crocodiles are generally found in a mangroves. Clear? Anybody else? Next is a mountain vegetation. Mountain vegetation, it is also known as a Himalayan vegetation or M-O-N-T-A-N-E, mountain vegetation, Himalayan vegetation or coniferous vegetation or alpine vegetation. Alpine vegetation. It is also known as the alpine vegetation. Renuka, still query? Your hand is still raised. Renuka. Okay. Next is the mountainous vegetation. Mangroves are generally growing in a delta such as a Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Mahanadi, and Ganga. Clear, Ritika? Any other? They are generally growing as a deltas such as the Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Mahanadi, and Ganga. And they are also sometimes growing in a estuaries. Those estuaries where the water has present in a stagnant form. Because the mangroves are growing in a saline water. In saline water. Now the fifth one, mountain vegetation. Mountain vegetation or mountainous vegetation or Himalayan vegetation or coniferous alpine vegetation. So as we read in a previous chapter, climate, when we move the upward direction, temperature falls. That process is known as rule number 18, raise your hand. Rule number 18, 19, raise your hands. Rule number 18, 19, 29. If any one of them, they are present, raise your hand. 18, 19, 29, 31, 31. I think 19 is a Jasleen Khosla. Jasleen. So in mountainous region, when we increase the height, same as when the temperature falls, same as the vegetation also varies. Vegetation also varies. At a distinct height, altitudinal regions, vegetation also affected. Himalayas are an area where a variety of plants grow. The climatic conditions here change with the altitude and the direction of slopes in relation to sun. The southern slopes of Himalayas having as a dense growth of vegetation. Southern slopes of Himalayas are having the dense growth of vegetation due to the sunlight, due to the insolation. Sunlight appears in the southern slopes of Himalayas, means the part of the Himalayas in India, as compared to the northern slopes. As compared to northern slopes having as a less growth of vegetation due to the sunlight not appears. Due to the sunlight not appears in the northern slopes of China. That's why that part is the comes under the cold region. But the southern slopes where the sunlight appears, southern slopes of Himalayas where the sunlight appears, it's supportive for the growth of a dense growth of vegetation. Dense growth of vegetation. In a tropical deciduous forest, generally as a tropical deciduous forest are found in a till 1000 meters of a height. 1000 meters of height. Our Jalandhar, it has located at the height of approximately as a 260 meters from a mean sea level. From mean sea level, it means as a, it is as the sum of the altitude, some height. No doubt, Jalandhar is a part of the plains, but that land is a higher comparatively the mean sea level. That sea level which remains as the same in all over the world. Clear? So till 1000 meters as a tropical deciduous forest and in wetlands. Wetlands are the those areas of mountains which are separated from a plains. The foothills of the mountains are considered under the Tarai region. In such Tarai, wetlands are known for the tropical evergreen forest. So these forests are generally found till as the 1000 meters of a height. 1000 meters of height. Afterwards, the 1000 meters towards the 3000 meters. 1000 to 3000 meters of height. 1000 meter to 3000 meters. There are generally as a coniferous forests are found. As per the increasing in a height, with the increasing in a height, same as the number of a vegetation also vary. Coniferous towards the alpine towards as the shrubs. It's due to as a temperature. Due to the low temperature and precipitation which has impact over a such vegetation. When we increases the height, the sizes of a leaves of a such vegetation, it becomes as a smaller. In a mountainous areas, trees are having as a small leaves and a sharper leaves due to the snowfall. It's due to the snowfall. I'm again repeating as a till 1000 meters in a plain areas as tropical deciduous forests are found. In wetlands where the mountains separated from the plains as a wetlands, marshy lands, Tarai regions are known for the tropical evergreen forest. These are known as the tropical evergreen forest. Afterwards, 1000 meters towards the 3000 meters. 1000 meters towards the 3000 meters, such vegetation is known as a coniferous vegetation. Coniferous, coniferous vegetation. It is known as the coniferous vegetation, which has lies till the height of 3000 meters. The important species of trees growing in a coniferous vegetation are pines, P-I-N-E-S, tropical evergreen forests. In a such mountain vegetation lies till 1000 meters where wetlands are there. Where dry conditions are there, tropical deciduous forests are there. Where the wetlands, Tarai regions are tropical evergreen. Afterwards, 1000 meters to 3000 meters has coniferous vegetation, which includes the important number of species of trees are pines, P-I-N-E-S, silver fir, S-I-L-V-E-R, silver fir, F-I-R, silver fir, deodar, D-E-O-D-A-R, D-E-O-D-A-R. Selvarfar. Deodar, silver fir, pines, silver fir, deodar, deodar, silver fir, cedar, C-E-D-A-R, cedar, silver fir, pine, deodar, are growing in a coniferous forest. They are growing in a coniferous forest. Coniferous forest. Afterwards, the 3,000 meters to the 3,500. 3,000 meters towards the 3,500. 3,000 meters towards the 3,500 as an alpine vegetation. It is known as alpine vegetation. 3,000 to 3,500, 3,000 to 3,500, known as the alpine vegetation. It is known as the alpine vegetation. Alpine vegetation. It is known as the alpine vegetation. The important number of species of trees. Species of trees growing in a alpine vegetation are alpine vegetation are silver fir, pines, junipers, and birches. B-I-R-C-H-E-S. B-I-R-C-H-E-S. Again, silver fir, junipers, pines, and birches are growing in a alpine vegetation. Afterwards, 3,500 towards 5,000 meters. 3,500 towards the 5,000 meters as shrubs are growing. Shrubs are growing. Alpine vegetation can't grow afterwards the 3,500 meters from a mean sea level. Vegetation, it can't grow, trees can't grow, but the shrubs and grasses are growing till height of a 5,000 meters. And afterwards, a 5,000 meters of a height towards 8,000 meters. Clear? Till that extent, not possible for a growth of a vegetation because of extremely cold weather conditions. These areas are completely lies under a snow-fed areas. Snow, it fall on a such areas as throughout the year. So above over the 5,000 meters, vegetation can't possible to grow. Why do the such vegetation having as a smaller leaves, Apran? Why do as the trees having as a smaller leaves? Because of a snowfall. Snowfall. If we assume that evapotranspiration, there is a no vegetation can't grow above the height of the 5,000 meters. Above the 5,000 meters. Yes, Dhiren. Yes, Renuka.
Sir, please repeat after shrubs.
After shrubs, not possible as a growth of a vegetation. More than the height of a 5,000 meters, vegetation can't grow in a such areas of a mountains. So I'm again repeating as a till 1,000 meters in a dry weather conditions, dry areas are known for the tropical deciduous forest. In wetlands till the 1,000 meters of a height as a tropical evergreen forest. Afterwards, 1,000 meters towards 3,000 meters as a coniferous forest. 3,000 meters towards 3,500 meters as a alpine vegetation. And afterwards, 3,500 towards 5,000 meters as a shrubs. Shrubs, grasses can grow. Shrubs and grasses, they can grow in a above the height of 3,500 to the 5,000 meters. 3,500 towards as a 5,000 meters as growth of shrubs and grasses. and there is not any name or a variety of till the height of 5,000 meters. Afterwards, 5,000 meters, not possible for a growth of a vegetation. Clear? Not possible as a growth of vegetation because of extremely cold weather conditions, snow-fed areas are lies under it. But till the height of 5,000 meters, snow melted. It melts with the changes in weather conditions. So this was as the mountain vegetation. Any questions still there? Any questions? These were the five categories of a natural vegetation. First, tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest, which green throughout the year, do not shed their leaves in a particular conditions. Second, as the tropical deciduous forest, which shed their leaves before after winters. Third, as the thorny shrubs, which are growing in a desert areas where rainfall as a less than 70 centimeters annually occur. Fourth one, as the mountain vegetation with increase in height, the variation in a vegetation occur. And fifth, as a mangroves. Mangroves growing in a deltas, estuaries, in a wetlands, where as the saline water has present for supportive for growth of a mangroves. Done. Next, as the second part of a chapter, as a wildlife. This as the first chapter of a first part of a chapter done as a natural vegetation, now as a wildlife. 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 So like as a flora, India has a variety of fauna due to the great diversity of the relief and climate. There are about 89,000 species of animals present in our country. 89,000 species of animals present in our country. Animals present in our country. The freshwater marine species of fish are near about 2,500, and it constitutes a 12% of a whole of the world. Out of the 9,000 birds of the world, 1,200 species of birds are only present in our country. 1,200 species of birds are only constitutes within Indian subcontinent. And as we learned earlier, as a 5 to 8% of amphibians, reptiles, mammals are present in our country. So as they prefer, all such kind of the variety is generally due to the tropical conditions. In a tropical conditions, as a variety of a plants can grow, tropical evergreen forest, as the plants grow, same as the variety of the animals, they are present, they are prefer for the living in a tropical conditions, in a hot, humid weather conditions. Hot and humid weather conditions. As they prefer hot, wet forests, so they are found in the dense rainy forests of Assam in the northeast and Kerala, Karnataka in the south of the India. South of the India. There are the different number of animals which are also found in parts of a Thar desert of Rajasthan. Wild asses dominate the arid regions of Run of Kutch. One-horned rhinoceros lies in wet parts of Assam. They live in swampy and marshy lands of Assam and West Bengal. The other animals put in the categories of mammals include the Indian bison, Indian buffalo, Nilgai, Chausinga as a four-horned deer, antelope, the black buck, which is generally lies in a Sariska National Park of Rajasthan. One of the conspiracy was occurred in relation to the black buck, as you heard in the news, the killing of a black buck. Black buck is the endangered species in our country. So there are a variety of the animals are present in our country, same as a different number of deers also present in our country. Kashmir stag, swamp deer, spotted deer, musk deer, black buck, barasingha, different number of animals are present in our country. Clear? Generally, as animals are categorized into the certain categories. On the basis of their presence, we can classify the animals into the certain categories. First is a normal species of animals. Normal species of animals. Normal species, those number of animals which are present in everywhere, which are present in our environment in everywhere. Animals present in everywhere are known as the normal species, which are known as the normal species. For example, cow, buffalo, dog, cat, these are the normal species of animals. Clear? First category as a normal species of animals. Second are the vulnerable species. Vulnerable species. V-U-L-N-E-R-A-B-L-E. A-B-L-E. V-U-L-N-E-R-A-B-L-E. Vulnerable are those number of species of animals, those species of animals which earlier lies in a normal, but due to the human factors, due to as a human interference, loss of the habitats, deforestation, due to the human factors, their population decreasing day by day. Population decreasing day by day. They may categorize in endangered. In near in future, they will categorize in endangered. Clear?